So I brought up COVID and the college football playoff. Alabama has reinstated. Just ridiculous. Trying to do the show by myself is so ridiculous. But either way, Alabama has reinstated their safety protocols from the 2020 football season when, of course, there was no vaccine at that point. Everybody was trying to figure out exactly what to do. It says, with COVID-19 cases surging nationally and games in the NFL being impacted by the pandemic again, Alabama is returning to its safety protocols from a year ago as it prepares to participate in the CFP. It says that the team's back to wearing masks in the facility, social distancing during meetings. More than 90% of the players are vaccinated and also have received their booster shots. That's kind of a big deal. But we have, of course, seen multiple instances of this Omicron variant for COVID affecting people that have their boosters as well. So I don't know that any of these things that they are doing, any of these protocols, are going to be able to help prevent the spread of this, because this thing is highly, highly contagious. So nobody has even discussed, really, from what I understand, what is going to happen if you have big-time starters or just massive position groups being pushed out of the date of the CFP, right? I don't believe that we have a forfeit rule for the playoff. So do they move the dates? Because this does not have anything to do with the Rose Bowl anymore. How far back can they push this? I'm very interested. Nick Saban said, am I concerned? I'm always concerned when there's an issue out there, and we want to do the best we can to help our players be concerned about the issue and respect it so that they have the best opportunity to stay safe. This is interesting. So what Alabama is doing, and this is going for all of the players, right? Georgia, Michigan, and Cincinnati. It says the players practiced on Monday, and then they're going to get a few days off to spend time with their families before they return and travel to Texas on December 26th. This is where the issue is going to come in, because they're all going home to visit with family, and then they have to come back, and they travel on December 26th. Now, this is like this for every team that's in the CFP. Saban said he and his staff are doing their best to educate players on the risks of the virus and sending them home with a, quote, care package with everything they need to stay safe. He said they're really bought in to do everything they can to stay safe. There's no guarantee, so we want to use every protocol we can to help them stay safe. This is going to be interesting. I mean, we've seen a ton of games postponed in the NFL. Tuesday, there's games being played because of a massive number of COVID positives. Vaccines, etc., it doesn't appear that those are really helping stop the spread of this. So if that is the case, what are we going to do as far as the playoff games? If Alabama ends up having an entire position group wiped out, or whatever it is, what is the next step? I don't know what the answer to that is. So I'm curious to see what they'll end up doing here, but it's going to be interesting to see. I will say that. My guess is they will allow it to be postponed so that we actually get the game in, because the ratings are going to be monster. And I think that they might almost be totally fine with moving these games off of New Year's Eve. So if we do have a bunch of positives, etc., we'll see. We'll see what happens. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.